Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Sorry that this video is coming out a little bit late. I've been spending some quality time with the newly introduced Tomogunchi. For those of you that have no idea what the heck this is, it is a new watch that contains a digital creature within Call of Duty Modern Warfare. It's kind of like a game within a game. For those of you that think the name sounds familiar, the Tomogunchi is based off of the real-world equivalent Tamagotchi, which were popular in the 90s. You take care of a digital creature by feeding it, bathing it, making sure that it's played with and happy so it doesn't die. Well, the same thing is happening here with the Tomogunchi, except it's a wristwatch and it constantly evolves with you. The reason that this watch is so different is because most of the watches in this game are there for just that single match, as to where the Tomogunchi is constantly changing and growing over the matches that you play. It's not just there for one game, it's there for your entire career in Call of Duty Modern Warfare. And just like the real world equivalent Tamagotchi, if you make a misstep, forget to feed it, forget to play with it, it will die and you'll have to restart all over again. Unfortunately, this little guy is in the shop for 1,000 COD points, but I have a feeling that this will change. Probably in Season 3, you might see a Tomogunchi available in the Battle Pass, so for anyone that's not willing or wanting to spend the 1,000 COD points, I would just say wait until Season 3 and you'll most likely get one of your own. The same thing happened with the kill-death ratio watch, and I'm expecting something similar to happen with this. So let's start things off by talking about the evolution. You're going to be starting with an egg, and trust me, if you've been at the egg form for a long time, don't stress about it because it does take in-game time for it to finally just hatch and crack open. There are four different forms that you can get to, the first one being the baby that comes out of the egg, a child that looks almost like a potato, a teen, which I refer to as a Cinnamon Toast Crunch Bite, and then finally you get the full adult. And there's a few different adults that you can get right now. One resembling a panda, one looks like Riley the dog, and the last one looks like a dragon or some sort of dinosaur. But there is rumors that there are secret Tomogunchis that could come from this, and until we discover those secrets, I have no idea what they could be. The evolution process does take a long time, so if you're still sitting there looking at your egg wondering when it's gonna hatch, it took mine about an hour and a half, and that was in-game time. The evolutions will happen while you're playing, so you're gonna hear a little chime or a little buzz coming from your creature, and when you check your watch, you'll see that it looks completely different. So when the egg hatches, things change immediately, because as an egg, it doesn't require anything. But then once it's born, it requires all of those faces that are on the side. These are the emotions of your Tomogunchi: hungry, dirty, unruly, and sleepy. And what we know as of right now is kills, objective scoring, kill streaks, and wins go towards fixing these things. So if one of these things are lit up, then you need to do that correlating thing in order to make it go away and make sure your Tomogunchi is happy. The problem is right now, it's not really clear what does what, so I'm trying to differentiate that still. I'm sorry, I don't have the answer at this moment, but as soon as I have the answer for what officially cures these ailments, I will make sure to update the description and I will pin a comment letting you know what exactly you need to do to cure each one of these statuses. It's actually not often you're going to see the statuses if you're playing pretty balanced. And what I mean by that is you're calling in streaks, you're capturing objectives, you're winning games, and of course you're getting kills. As long as you're doing those four things pretty consistently, then you should never have to worry about your Tomogunchi. It should be okay for the most part. Sometimes though, things just don't go your way. So you might be getting killed a lot, you might lose a match, you might end up losing your streak, you might not get a streak at all, you might not capture an objective, and then that's when your Tomogunchi is gonna be upset because you didn't do anything. There's also a bonus method of evolving your Tomogunchi. And I noticed that this comes directly from winning matches, but apparently every single pet has a different way to fill the bonus charge meter. My pet specifically gets a bonus charge from winning matches. Yours might get a bonus charge from capturing objectives, or getting killstreaks, or planting objectives, or getting top three wins in a free-for-all match. Mine come from every win. So every two wins, my bar will be completely full. And in order to bank those bonus charges, all I have to do is use the watch interact gesture. This is the one that quickly flicks the wrist, and then boom, those charges are banked. And as you can see on the screen right now, it's completely depleted, and I'm ready for another two wins in order to get some more bonus charges towards an evolution. Now, this allows you to evolve faster than normal, but to get to this point I am at right now with this Cinnamon Toast Crunch, it has taken me 6 hours. 6 hours. So don't expect to be doing this in two games. It doesn't work that way. And from what I understand, I still have one more evolution to go, and that's the adult form. And I've noticed since I've gotten to this form, the Tomogunchi is a little more insatiable. It wants more things done. It wants me to continuously feed the kills, continuously capture objectives, continuously get wins. So what I've been doing is I've been playing a lot of Infected. Infected matches go pretty quickly, and pretty much every single match you play is going to be a victory, because as long as all of you are infected, that counts as a win. So I would definitely say playing Infected has been faster than just doing Ground War, but at the same time, you have to be a little bit careful, because if your Tomogunchi wants kill streaks or wants you to capture objectives, you can't necessarily do that in Infected. But I haven't really seen that happen yet. Crossing my fingers, knocking on wood, I guess we'll have to wait and see. To be completely honest though, I don't know what you have to do in order to kill this thing. I mean, the only way that I could see somebody actually killing their Tomogunchi is by simply neglecting to do anything and just sitting there killing themselves over and over again, getting killed by the enemies, not capturing objectives. It would be really hard to go out of your way to do all of that. If it does come down to something happening accidentally, or maybe you're just trying to push yourself too far and you can't capture the 10 objectives in a single match, I don't really know what it takes to kill this thing. It does seem kind of strange for it to just up and die, even though you're playing the game and you're doing what you need to do. I've just found that playing Ground War allows me to do all of the crucial and essential things for the Tomogunchi to allow it to remain happy and not always be in a neutral stance. This could change from person to person though, because every single one of these creatures have their own personalities and they may require different things. So what I'm telling you here today for my particular setup may not reflect what you particularly have. You may have to focus on captures while I have to focus on wins. You might have to focus on streaking and getting kill streaks. I don't know. I might have to focus on getting top three. So it all depends. Maybe there would be a reason for somebody wanting to kill their Tomogunchi just to kind of get a different creature. But anyway, I have rambled on way too long about this watch. It's pretty fun. It's interesting to say the least. I'm still trying to figure out the mystery. So if you guys know the specific things you have to do for the moods, being hungry, dirty, unruly, and sleepy, please feel free to leave it down below in the comments section. I think I know the one. I think hungry is probably kills, because it just makes sense. If they want to be fed, you want to get kill feeds. So getting kills just makes sense for hungry. So I'm thinking that's what that one is. Easy enough, simple enough. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. No reason to take it to 10 minutes. If you did, take a moment of your time to click the like button down below. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming very soon. And of course, do not forget to ring the bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you when my videos go live. I really wonder how many times I said Tomogunchi in this video. Probably at least like 24 times. Anyway, guys, I'll see you later. Peace.